Yo, subscribe. Fino Boxing. Now enjoy the video.
All right, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Hi, Danny. This is Jeremy Herriges with Fansided.com. I was talking to Gabe Rosado a couple weeks ago, and he sourced the bad blood between you two to an incident that
happened. Yeah, I think I've seen that interview.
Yeah. that happened in 2018 at the Cosmopolitan leading up to the Triple G Canelo rematch, he said. Do you have any recollection of that? And I was interested to hear your side of the events that may have transpired.
Well, I mean, I've said it so many times, but it's basically generally, I just think it was one of those situations where he had said some things that he was physically going to do to me if he ever seen me in person. And so I seen him in person and gave him the opportunity to do just that. And his energy wasn't the same. And so I kind of questioned him, you know, why he make those statements. And overall, it was just pretty much to get a fight. So I respect any fighter who could be honest, but I can't respect a fighter who is saying disrespectful things to me as a man. And so this is why this fight is being made, because of some of his past comments and the blatant disrespect that I've been taking, you know, over the years, honestly. And he's a peer of mine since the amateurs into the professional ranks. And so I've always said that his career didn't go the way that he planned. And my career has gone exactly how I wanted to go, you know, with a minor setbacks. But, you know, it's just, I think he's bitter. And, you know, now he has an opportunity to get everything that he wanted, you know, and boxing is one of those sports to where, you know, you can have a crappy career, your whole entire career, but one fight can actually change you and catapult you into being a superstar. And this is his opportunity. And so he's talked his way into this opportunity. But at the same time, how I'm looking at it is just, you know, giving a man his words to eat and allowing him to know that there's different levels, and I'm not non-deserving of this opportunity or the push that I've had throughout my career, and more so just to put a little bit more respect.
Thank you, Danny, and best of luck.
Thank you.
Cynthia, please.
Hey, Danny, Cynthia Conde from Ring TV. I just wanted to piggyback off of Jeremy's question, because he basically had almost the same question I had. But going back to that incident, I did speak with him the other day, and he said that he just doesn't like you as a person. Was there any other incident before that you guys had any kind of bad blood or something happened? Or was it just basically your guys' come up and he didn't come up the way he was expecting?
I really don't know why he has so much hate for me in his heart, but when you're a hater, you create any reasons to hate somebody. And when you see someone who you think you're supposed to be on that same level, having the success that you desire and you want, and you can't get it, whether it's because, you know, you don't have the same skill set, or you're not winning fights, or you're just a whatever you are, I mean, I can't speak for it because I'm not a hater. You know, I can't speak on how a hater mentality thinks. I'm one who congratulates. I'm one who supports anybody in the sport of boxing. And so if I have someone that I want to fight, it's not going to be because, you know, they got the push that I didn't get. It's going to be mainly because I want to be in a position to be a champion. And if they're preventing me from being a champion, then I want to fight you in order to be a champ. But it is not simply because, you know, you've gotten a push that I didn't get, and I'm fighting you because the system didn't, you know, push me the same way. And I took my extensive, successful amateur background has allowed me from the very start to get the push from the Al Haymans of the world and the Golden Boys of the world and the Zones of the world and the Matchrooms of the world. So I purposely put in the work as an amateur to be able to